Let's learn how to use the Mongoose API to interact with the MongoDB database. I'll be using the Node REPL to simplify things. Require Mongoose, which provides an ODM API that maps a JavaScript object to a JSONB document. The first thing we want to do is create a schema that describes the field names and their respective types. Here, the name field will be a string type. Then create the user model by providing a name and the schema. The name will be associated with the collection. Now let's construct a document. Instantiate the model with the name property. You can see the user object here. Save the document by calling the respective method provided by the model. If you didn't know already, all Mongoose queries are asynchronous, which means you should pass a callback to know whether it has failed or finished. Now let's check out our data. Open a new tab and enter the Mongo shell. If you show your databases, you'll see that it's not there. What's going on? Well, a database only exists if it has a collection, and a collection exists if it has a document. The document was never saved because we never opened up a connection to the database. Let's fix that. Go back to the Node REPL and require the connection file. Now the transaction in the queue will be saved. Go back to the Mongo shell and confirm that DB name is there. Then switch to DB name and show all collections. You'll find that users is lowercase and pluralized. This is implicitly done by Mongoose. If you want to give your collection an explicit name, use a third argument when creating a model. To list all documents, run db.users.find. As you've noticed before, there are fields other than name in the document. The underscore underscore v field is managed by Mongoose to keep track of internal revisions of the document. The underscore id field is the MongoDB object ID. It's a unique hexadecimal string that is comprised of the time, the machine identifier, the process ID, and the counter. Now let's update the document. The first argument is the query. The second argument is the document. The third optional argument is the options like upsert and multi. And the last argument is a callback function that receives the error and the full response from Mongo. It's best practice to handle the error first. Now let's find all documents in the user's collection. The first argument is the criteria. I left it empty so it matches all documents in the collection. The second argument is a callback with an array of matched documents. You'll see that the number got typecasted into a string and the valid field was never saved. This shows that the Mongoose schema validates your values before saving them to the database. Finally, let's remove our document. The first argument is a filter and the second argument is a callback which forces the operation to execute. To verify that the document has been removed, find all documents again. To drop all documents in a collection, run collection.drop on the model. The collection is no more, as well as the database. Feel free to check out the Mongoose documentation to learn more about the API. And that's a basic overview on using Mongoose to save, find, update, and remove documents.